Mervyn Turner. I spoke to you before, Mervyn, about sort of now training Prince Patel.
Yeah.
Well underway now. You've had your first bout with him.
Yeah, we've had our first fight.
How do you find it is? How do you find training Prince?
Fantastic. Yeah, I've got to say that we've come a long way in a short time, and we've got a long way to go. But no, it's been really good, really, really good. Prince is a real student of the game, and you know, he's great in the gym. He'll do whatever, and he learns so quickly. It's fantastic, I must say.
Training with
surprisingly,
yeah. Training with Mervyn Turner. He's obviously sort of got his own stable, Shamrock Boxing, and you're with Frank Warren over at Box Nation. And do you feel sort of Mervyn's got the contacts in the game that's going to be able to draw you on?
Definitely, that's one of the reasons why I went with Merv as well, because he understands the business, and that's not just in the coaching aspects. He understands what he has to do in quick fights and where to put my career, like how fast to push for titles, how slow to push for titles. So he understands all that stuff, but as well as Frank understands that stuff as well. But obviously, two brains are better than one. And obviously, if you've got two people like Mervyn and Frank looking after you, can't really go wrong, to be honest.
How much does Mervyn push you in the gym? How hard are you?
Very hard, because neither of us want to look stupid. You can't say you're going to be a superstar and not train like a superstar. So obviously you put the work in. You had a little glimpse today at me lifting some of the weights and train like a machine.
That's exactly what I was going to go on to. So Mervyn, you've got contacts local to yourself, and you've been able to sort of help with.
Yeah, I think it's important to get, you know, the complete picture. And when Prince came along, you know, what people forget, the flyweight division is a small division, and what we've got here is a light flyweight. So he's moved up a weight, and he's fighting flyweights and beyond. You know, his last fight, the guy came into the ring 9 stone 2 on the night. Prince can't get up to 9 stone 2 no matter what we do. So we've got to make him the strongest light flyweight there is out there. And before, he wasn't doing much of that. He wasn't doing strength work and so forth. So now, you know, we've had a good few weeks, few months now, and he's come on leaps and bounds, and he's lifting more than, you know, we imagined at this stage that he would be. So yeah, that's come on great, and that's due to, you know, the strength and conditioning coach and what we're doing in the gym. But yeah, it's coming really well, that side of it.
Where do we see Prince in at the end of 2016? Where would you hope to?
Well, that's, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm Prince's coach. That is down to Frank Warren. He's the best promoter out there at making champions like Prince. So, you know, at the end of the day, we're guided by Frank and his team. But I want to see, you know, Prince pushed. I want to see him in tougher fights. I don't want knockovers and that sort of thing. And by the end of 2016, we want to see some belts around his waist and moving up very quickly in a small division. So we have to be prepared for those fights to come very quickly, quicker than with some of the other weights where you've got lots of boxes and you've got that bit more time. With Prince, as I said to him, you know, it's a double-edged sword. It's great because you can move quickly, but on the other hand, you have to be ready, because if Frank phones us up and says, right guys, you've got a WBO European title shot, or you've got an international or whatever, we've got to be ready for it. We can't turn around and say, oh no, we're not ready. We're ready now.
Yeah. On the flip side, I sort of spoke to you briefly about it before, but end of 2016, where do you want to be? First year, you had 3 fights.
Second year, I want to be more active personally. I want to be out there more often.
A lot more active.
Definitely a lot more active. I want to basically showcase a lot more skills. I don't want to be someone who's good when it's in front of a mic, because obviously someone like me is always going to look good in front of a mic.
Yeah.
Got cheekbones, jawline. But someone like that. What I'm saying basically is the in-ring ability needs to be shown this year, and people start knowing me as someone who can fight and can talk and looks good.
I was going to say, the one thing that is consistent with people out there, you know, the end of the day, the kid does talk, but no one ever has ever said he can't fight, because he can fight. And now we need to start showing that side of it, and backing up the words, and backing up the people that are giving us the opportunities.
You're with Frank Warren, and you remain to be loyal to Frank Warren. But there is Shamrock Promotions. Your trainer runs Shamrock Promotions.
Yeah.
Is that like an option? For either, would you like to box on a Shamrock show or?
Yeah, I'd like to box on a Shamrock show. Obviously, be on the shows that Merv promotes and manages. But it would probably, if I needed like a warm up fight before a big fight, I may get like a quick 6 or 4 rounder going into a championship fight. That's if I needed some fights. But I'm quite happy boxing on Box Nation and with Frank Warren.
We're looking for Box Nation to push Prince's career forward. If they're scheduled, you know, he needs a fight quickly and they haven't got the shows and we have, then I'm sure, you know, Mr. Warren's team would approach us and say, look, put him on that and get him a fight and get him ready for the next level. That's the only case where it happened. We are with Box Nation, with Prince Patel, and we're looking for Frank Warren to push his career forward. And they do enough shows, and they know exactly what they're doing to be able to handle his career.
And they're good quality shows as well. Like
fantastic.
December 19th was, you had 2 world titles on there. You've got February 13th, which has got another world title on there. Frank does. I personally think Frank's doing the best shows in Europe. And I'm really glad to be part of that organisation.
A name that gets brought up a lot when you're around, Charlie Edwards.
Yeah.
He's working with Matchroom, but do you believe that Frank Warren's a person to be able to deliver you the fight, you know, cross-platform?
Don't matter who the guy's working with, he will get beaten. Could be working with Golden Boy or Top Rank. Me and him will step into the ring. And the outcome's inevitable, that's me inflicting pain. But at the moment, he's got a British eliminator with Luke Wilton, and then winner of that fight's the winner of Selby and Butcher. He comes out with a British title. Pretty sure Frank can organise a British title fight between me and Charlie. Let's just hope he doesn't get beat beforehand, because I want to be the guy to take his oath. I'd like his virginity to be taken by me.
Well, brilliant. It's nice to finally sort of meet up with the two of you together.
Can I say some thank yous to my sponsors?
Mm-hmm.
I want to thank Pink Hippo, the Leander Group, Everready. They allow me to train full-time by giving me a monthly wage, etc. And I'm grateful for that. Also, can I thank the guy on my top? He puts a lot of power into me. And I want to thank the man next to me for actually putting his time and effort into me, because he doesn't have to work with me. Like, he's got his own businesses, a very successful man, manages and promotes loads of boxers. I think he's got about 30 you might manage at the moment. He's got a strong stable as well. Doesn't have to actually coach someone like me, because obviously there's a lot of bad reputation around me. Doesn't have to do that. And I want to thank Frank Warren as well, and everyone else in his team, Andy Aylin, Jason McClory, because once again, they don't even have to work with me, because they could produce world champions after world champions. I'm just another name, but I will be a world champion added to that name. I'm grateful for the opportunities.
Brilliant. Well, once again, thanks for both your time. Best of luck in 2016. And I'm sure I'll catch up with you both again soon.
And thank you for the interview.